Hello students, in the previous video I have explained the concept of electronic spectroscopy, its application as well as how the transition takes place. As we know that once the molecule which absorbs the radiation, then electron gets excited from the lower energy state to the higher energy state, or it is in transition from the highest occupied molecular orbital to the lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. As we know that a molecule which contains the electronic, vibrational and rotational energy levels. Here one electronic energy level that consists of a large number of the vibrational energy levels with a lesser energy separation, or each vibrational energy level that consists of a large number of rotational energy levels with a very less energy separation. So as the molecule which absorbs the radiation, the electron which is present in the molecule that is gets excited from the rotational vibrational energy level of the one electronic state to the rotational vibrational energy level of the other electronic state. It means this concept, once again we can understood by using this energy level diagram. Here we can see the one electronic state, or we can call it as a ground state, and it is a one more electronic energy level. Here we can see the energy gap here. The energy gap between the two electronic energy levels is very large or more, and here in the one electronic state we can see there are a several number of energy levels that is called as a vibrational energy levels, and here the energy separation is very less compared to that of the two electronic energy levels. And once again in between these vibrational energy levels there are number of energy levels with a very less energy separation that are called as the rotational energy levels. And vibrational energy levels can be represented as a V0, V1, V2, V3, etc. And rotational energy levels like R0, R1, R2, R3, etc. That is same in similar in case of excited state also. So in the ground state electrons may occupy the rotational or vibrational energy level of the one electronic state, so that we can say that the transition of electron is from one of the rotational vibrational energy level of the one electronic state to the vibrational rotational energy level of the other electronic state. Next let us discuss the types of transition. We know that the molecule in the ground state which contains the electrons that is in the three principal orbitals like a sigma, pi and n orbital, and here the sigma and pi orbitals which are formed due to the overlapping of a two atomic orbital, so that the sigma and pi orbital which also contains the antibonding sigma star and pi star orbital, but the non-bonding n orbital do not containing any antibonding orbital because it do not formed due to the overlapping of two atomic orbital. So from this we can say that the transition of electron is from a bonding sigma, pi and n non-bonding n orbital to the sigma star, pi star orbital. Mainly there are four types of transitions like sigma to sigma star transition, n to sigma star transition, pi to pi star transition and n to pi star transition. Let us discuss one by one. First one is the sigma to sigma star transition. Here this type of transition are observed in the case of a saturated hydrocarbon, or the sigma to sigma star transition is the transition of electron that is from the bonding sigma orbital to the antibonding sigma star orbital, and here it clearly indicates that it is the transition of electron from the sigma orbital to the sigma star, so that it contains only the compounds contains only the single bond that can exhibit this type of transition. So that saturated hydrocarbon, for example methane or ethane, can exhibit this type of transition. And the sigma to sigma star transition, which requires a higher energy for the transition because the sigma bond is very strong, and also here in the sigma bond all the electrons which may be outermost electrons which may be involved in the bond formation, so that this type of transition which requires a higher energy. And the next one, that is N2 sigma star transition, that means the transition of electron from the non-bonding N orbital to the sigma star, anti-bonding sigma star orbital. Here the saturated compounds which contain a hetero atom that can exhibit this type of transition, N2 sigma star transition, and example is a methyl iodide, methyl chloride, etc. And this type of transition which may require a lesser energy than that of the sigma to sigma star transition. Next, third one, pi to pi star transition. Transition, if the electrons are promoted from the pi orbital to the pi star orbital, then it is called as a pi to pi star transition. And unsaturated compound, in the sense the compound which contains a double bond or a triple bond, that may exhibit the pi to pi star transition. Examples are any saturated compounds, any ethene, ethylene, etc. Then the last one, N2 pi star transition. This type of transition which are observed in the case of acids, ketones, aldehydes, etc. That means the unsaturated compound which contain a hetero atom that may exhibit N2 pi star transition, N2 pi star transition. And here this also requires a lesser energy when compared to the sigma to sigma star transition. And here the transition of electron, that is from the N orbital to the pi star orbital. And all the four types of transitions can be represented by this energy level diagram. Here we can represent four types of transitions. This one, horizontal line, which represents the transition of electron, and here it is a sigma and pi, N, pi star and sigma star orbitals. Here the first one, it requires a higher energy, sigma to sigma star transition, which requires a higher energy. And here this represents the N2 sigma star transition. It is a transition from a pi to pi star, and this one is N2 pi star transition. So this is all about the types of transitions. Thank you.